holy poopy language in my last video. I'm gonna try and clean it up for the children. So I think I'm in Facebook jail. Not my profile, but my artist page. I mean, I didn't get any notifications. One day I just tried to post a photo. It said something about repeatedly violating community standards. Say what?
That's so ridiculous, I won't even bother to deny it.
So I'm trying to figure out what the good golly heck happened. I mean, you'd think they'd send a note. Dear Facebook bond servant.
You are terminated.
I did notice after a little digging that one of my prints quietly got rejected on the products page. It's actually a painting I did quite a few years ago called Scratch. Shout out to my girl Sayla who bought it. Hey girl. I'm thinking maybe it turned up in the feed of a devoutly religious person who perhaps, you know, didn't take very kindly to all that cleavage with the sight of Virgin Mary. But this painting does have her reasons. I'm not just a cheap shock jock. The idea came out of an innocent observation that maybe one of the downsides of these ancient religions is that, you know, spiritual women seem to get robbed of their sexuality and vice versa. I mean, maybe not so much now in certain pockets of the Western world, but I think it's fair to say that there's a teensy-weensy gap between the Virgin and the Magdalene culturally, a little bit. And ipso facto, I think women have, for centuries, been trying to marry the two Marys. It's just a hypothesis. You know, the lady pastor should be able to be nasty as she wanna be. Thank you very much. And the liberated woman can be more than just a piece of booty in this male-dominated matrix.
Lesbian! We're all thinking it, aren't we?
Incidentally, that's why I think it's so important that a sexually emancipated woman named Madonna happened. Just saying. Anyway, that's what this painting is about. I respect all religions. I think a lot of good comes from religion. So don't be hating on me, bookface. That was such a breakup with me on a post-it moment. I didn't even get a chance to take it down. Whatevs. Time for the show.
Ugh. Let's go.
So this past Halloween, I went to Toronto to get a tattoo and I made a trip over to Church Street to see the mural because I heard there were plans to tear it down. Believe it? What? What? So after almost 10 years of holding on to her, I've decided to sell the original. This was painted back in 2013, I'm pretty sure it was 2013, after I was approached by my pal James Fowler to submit a package for the Church Street mural project. At first, I told him, I can't do that. A 24-inch painting takes me months. A wall would just be bonkers. I'd still be down there filming this from the scaffolding. And you know, not to mention, my paintings aren't exactly mural material. And I told him I wasn't that kind of artist, but he was so sweet. He really encouraged me to submit something and told me that if it was accepted, they would look for an actual mural artist, which they did. Very talented guy named Cristiano Di Araujo. He did a sensational job. Also, because the wall they chose was wider than my painting dimensionally, he added the cop car and the crowd with the Marlboro men positioned like a gay Where's Waldo. I do remember the artists were all invited to, I think it was referred to as a talking circle. We were to be addressed by the elders. It was all very Dances with Wolves meets Paris is Burning. I brought a little notebook to jot down any thoughts that struck me. And the thing I remember writing was visibility at any cost. Because in the 70s, there was no Lady Gaga riding a pink unicorn, just a 1930s Marlene Dietrich movie at 3 o'clock in the morning.
Give me a kiss.
Most minorities have families. A little gay baby, is born an alien. One thing that got mentioned a lot in the circle were the bathhouse raids of 1981. 4 bathhouses that were raided, 300 arrests, and apparently it was the largest mass arrest in Toronto history. They called it Operation Soap.
What do you mean by that? A crack
First thing I etched out was the androgynous figure, sort of standing there defiantly in the face of an inflamed public opposition. And in a situation here where the people who are meant to save you from catastrophe are scheming behind the scenes to ambush you and take you down, in the face of that, is this figure who has the courage to be visible at any cost. She could be a drag queen, she could be transgender, she's just an androgynous figure. The telephone pole lit by firelight was supposed to look like a crucifix because, you know, religion was being weaponized against gay people. It's so much fun to do all your finger wagging in groups. Footnote, I do think this one ended up looking a little like Madonna because for me, Truth or Dare was the first time I'd seen gay people presented lovingly and laughing with friends and just normal and cool. It was kind of a reset button for me. Even though back in 91 when I saw that movie, every time something gay happened, the whole theater groaned and my heart sank. I still caught a definite taste of life outside my narrow frame of reference, and it made me feel a little better. So, pinch of Madonna in there. When I finished it, I thought, there's no way anyone is gonna put this on a public wall. You know, my stuff is very niche. It's not exactly a ring of Keith Haring figures holding hands, but it was accepted and I was thrilled. And when I saw Cristiano's beautiful work taking shape, I got really excited and I was very happy. And they unveiled it for World Pride 2014, which was in Toronto, so that was pretty cool. I've held on to this original painting for a long time, and I think now that the days are numbered for that mural, I thought it was the perfect time to make a available for anyone who would like a piece of Toronto history. That's right, bitches. By the way, after seeing the mural, we stayed for Halloween, and after 2 years of being away from Toronto and isolating, it was fantastic to see Church Street so vibrant. You want to see creativity? Take a stroll down Toronto's gay village on Halloween night. It's pretty fantastic. Okay, so here she is, and she's listed on my website, but just before we close, I want to say that if there's a buyer in the general Toronto area, I will hand deliver her. So if you're interested, go to troybrooks.com, or you can email me direct at info@troybrooks.com, and let's find her a new home.
Tina!
Like and subscribe!